and love this piano. I'm going to start out with a tune called After Hours. Avery Parrish was the piano player who recorded it. It was recorded in 1940, maybe 1939. And when I used to play on the South Side, the brothers and sisters would come in when I played at the Cornell Lounge and they'd say, play the national anthem because it was called the Black National Anthem. And it's a beautiful piece and one of my favorites. Now, we all play it differently. We play it our own way because this stuff is written down. About 11 or 12 years earlier, Pine Top Smith came out with Pine Top's Boogie. was kind of a dance, and he'd give directions on how to dance and what to do. And I say, stop, stop, everybody stops, and then he starts, thumbs up. Okay, this is my version of Pine Top's Boogie, about 1928 or 29 he recorded it. And they don't believe me, so it's no use saying that anymore.
Thank you.
have such good taste. I think I'm going to play you one of my tunes. I lived in New Orleans back in the 50s for about 4 years. And I hung around Professor Longhair. Maybe some of you know who he was. And there was a bass line. I made up my own bass line, but it sounds New Orleans-ish. And so on. Well, I wrote a song for my dog called Pooch Piddle. And the dog's name was Karina. She's not with me anymore, but she used to accompany and sit by the piano, accompany me at concerts and so on. And this goes out to her wherever she may be. I sound better if I'm drinking. I love this piano. It plays by itself. It's pretty remarkable. It really is. This is tune I wrote for the late great Mama Yancey. Her husband was Jimmy Yancey, and he played the most beautiful sad blues. After he passed away, I had the privilege of accompanying her at the University of Chicago Folk Festival and at various places and blues places in Chicago. And she was the real thing. She could swear and drink more than any man on this planet. And sometimes she'd stay over at the house and I'd say, what do you want for breakfast? It was always the same thing. Burnt toast, burnt bacon, and a beer. And I'm pretty good at burning food. And her name was Estella Mama Yancey, and so this goes out to her. I call it Stella.
Thank you.
By the way, I don't make mistakes. Those are non-harmonic passing tones. That's a high-class musical term. A lot of the old boogie and blues players took some tunes that were popular, or some old folk tunes, and boogie-woogie-ized them. I made up that, and it's I'm going to get it in Wikipedia, boogie-woogie-ized. It's a verb. Boogie-woogie is something that has this repetitive bass. And so on. Well, this is my version of Swanee River Boogie. Albert Amundson, Pete Johnson tore it apart. I started it out with a little gospel version of it, and then I go into the boogie-woogie version of Swanee River Boogie.
Thank you.
By the way, I can remember tunes, but I can't remember anything else. So I just want to tell you before I forget, I have some CDs in the back table, and they're going cheap tonight for $15 because I got to pay off my college loan, so I know pick some up. From the Duke Ellington songbook, In a Sentimental Mood.
Thank you.
blues time. Should we take a break? Yeah, let's take a little break and I'll come back and do a few more. Is Dot Dockery here by any chance?
Yes, he is.
Oh, come on up. We got a treat in store.
And for those of you who don't There is a little bar and grill called Greentown Tavern at the end of the hall on the street level, which is one floor up, which is the fourth floor. I lose Cub Scouts all the time too. You are welcome to bring the glass of wine or beer or something down here.
Oh, he told me not to tell anybody, tomorrow is his birthday. So come on. It's his girlfriend, Nina's birthday today. Okay. One of them will happen. Okay, testing. Testing. Do we have any other birthdays in the house? Check this out, and then we'll take a little break. Okay, but first let me do something. Play. have dinner afterwards.
That sounds good to me.
And you're gonna buy my CDs.
Yes.
No, you don't have to. You know why they named the street after me? Because sometimes after a job, I gotta know where I live.
That's a good way of looking at it.
I go like this. And you yell, yeah.
Yeah.
Can you do that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or you can make up any word you want, like reve or whatever it is.